Konnichiwa. Hello everyone. This is the Doc in Japan. Today I'd like to talk about one of my favorite topics, coffee, and some new materials that are popping up in the world that are useful in cooking and brewing coffee and in other things. So several years ago, I posted a video. I'll try to put a link to it about my recipe for brewing coffee in an Aeropress. I've been using an Aeropress for about 10 years. My current press is about 5 years old, and I noticed that there were scratches inside of the chamber here that are caused when this plunger passes through. So I found out that the factory will send spare parts, so you don't have to buy an entirely new assembly of plastic parts. You can just buy the ones you need. So I got a new chamber and a new plunger. The manufacturer has changed the materials that the plunger is made out of. This used to be made out of what I would call rubber, but the new one, which appears to be identical if you look at them side by side without looking at them very closely, the new one is made out of silicone. I'm not a material scientist, so I guess that they're both referred to as rubber or elastomers. The old one apparently was made out of thermoplastic or TPE, and the new one, I believe, is an LSR, which means liquid silicone rubber. One of the problems with the old one, which you may have encountered with various things that are made out of rubber, is that it oozes this sticky material on the sides. Perhaps this new silicone plunger will alleviate that issue, and it may even solve my problems with the scratches that have occurred through hundreds of uses of this press. Perhaps what may be happening is that coffee gets mixed up with the coffee oils and the mineral oils that are inside of this food safe rubber material, and that causes some of the scratching that's been happening for me. Only time will tell. I've only been using the silicone material for about a week, and it seems to work very well, but I'm not sure how it will hold up over time. Interesting enough, the old rubber material, these were like $6 a piece, and the new ones are $3.50, so the silicone material for the time being is cheaper. So I'd love to hear your experience with old traditional style rubber materials versus silicone materials. Have you encountered them? If you brew coffee in an Aeropress, have you used both of the plunger types, and what has your experience been? Perhaps you've encountered silicone and rubber in other food circumstances. I know a lot of times recently silicone is being used in baking and freezing materials. I've even seen that car parts are starting to be made out of silicone rubbers. Windshield wipers are now available in a silicone material, and be interesting to see how the two materials stack up against each other in terms of function and longevity. Thank you for watching my videos. I look forward to being able to share a cup of coffee with all of you sometime in the near future. Stay safe, and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Mata ne.